Alright, hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Grandia. I am SIMSteven, also known as Fenrel, and looks like we're going to go to get some herbs for this little sick boy that we met in the forest on our way out of the Dom Ruins. Just kind of letting you know in advance, this area is going to be pretty boring. Admittedly, it's probably the most boring area in the entire game, so there's probably not going to be a whole lot for me to do here. Or to show, just, I kind of got to get through this place just for the sake of walkthrough purposes, but, yeah, I'm not too fond of this area, and if I sound kind of out of it already, well, I had a long day at work, but I still feel like playing through this just because, you know, I feel like recording and kicking back and playing some games. Anyways, we actually can bust down this board here and go to the Herb Mountain, as it's called. But yeah, as I've said, it's kind of boring back there. So, probably an interesting episode. But it's a very short area, thankfully. So, yeah, we'll probably be getting through here as quick as possible. And I'll probably be cutting out a lot of fights here. So, yeah. And maybe we'll get to the start of the next area. But I should warn you. Anyways, Phoenix is explaining there's some monsters back there, and just like, I'm gonna split this board with one of my board splitting kicks. Yeah! Yow, yow, ouch! That was not all that smart. Either way, are you okay, Jason? Did you hurt yourself? Guess it hurt less little. Let's go find some sulfur weed. And, well, the board is now down. Couldn't go here before, but we got to go to a place called the Herb Mountains. Anywho, I went back to New Parm off screen, and I got Sue her earth magic, and I should let you know that this is probably one of the last areas in the game you'll be last times you'll be able to go back to New Parm to well, we're going to hit a point of no return really soon. So, yeah. Just warning you on that about now. You can see we've got, as you can see, Justin, Fina, and Sue have their main attack magic at level 6. And Sue's earth magic is only at level 1. So, yeah, I bought that with the mana egg we got in the Dom Ruins. There's only one in there. So, yeah, we got one more school magic, and pretty soon we'll be getting forest magic, because that's the combination of water and earth. I'm going to show you a little bit of a trick here of what you can do if you just want to level up one character's skills at a time. Hopefully I don't have auto battle on right now, and I'm going to cancel it if it is. Alright, so one interesting thing about the combat system is you can set it up so that each character can be set to auto battle, and you can manually control whoever you want. So you can see I've set Sue up to be manually controlled, and Justin and Fina are pretty much going to use their normal attacks. So I'm going to set it up so that single tactics go, and if you look at the portraits at the top of the screen, you'll see that Justin and Fina are both on auto, and Sue is now on manual control because I set it up per character. Very nice little feature that they added to the game, and Sue just did a voice clip, a very generic voice clip, where she says, "You can't get away with that!" I don't think that's really anything interesting to say about Earth Magic. I don't think they really say, you know, give acknowledgement to the element they're using unless you're using an attack form of magic. So when she's like, "You can't get away with that," I think she can use that for any support magic. But anyways, there was a digging spell. All it really does is boost your defense. And that's really all there is to say about that. It hits all your party members, so the more party members you have, the more skill points you'll get. But beyond that, not really much to say about the earth element until we get to the higher levels of spells. Just the first level element is kind of Yeah, not all that great, but then again, not many of them really are. I mean, for fire magic, you have just... Oh, crap. Poison, yes. Good thing I put on my earrings, even though Justin still got hit by that. But yeah, all the first level elemental spells are kind of boring, but you gotta start using those before you can get some of the better spells, so it's kind of a trade-off. Anyways, I picked Earth Magic because I believe it increases defensive skill whenever you level it up, so yeah, that's why I put it on Sue first of all. Let's see here, what do we got? As you might guess, Herb Mountain is just kind of a big mall, kind of high. It's got all kinds of rocks and stones and weeds and lots of pot jokes and cracks all around. But yeah, you can kind of guess that there's not going to be all that much interesting as far as loot or monsters. I believe a lot of the enemies you find around here are just... reskins and or rematches or just some of the same enemies from various places we've already been to before. So again, one of the reasons why I say it's probably one of the most boring places in the entire game. So I think the bugs here are new, but I believe the spiders and the crawler enemies or the centipede enemies, I think we fought both of those before. And there's, like I said, not too much interesting to say about this area. I don't think there's any worthwhile drops from the enemies. I don't think there's anything, you know, I don't think there are many items that are worth getting just lying around the mountain. So I'm probably just going to be running around picking up weeds and... weeds and herbs and all kinds of pot joke reference items. So yeah, pretty much just be a very short episode for you, and be a lot of editing work for me because I don't feel like showing all these fights. But yeah. Oh, there's one kind of self item. Justin, this is white self weed. We can only use the red type. Well, excuse me. Should mention something about it is you can still use the white sulfur weed items just kind of as a healing item or what, I don't forget what their effect is, but yeah, the white sulfur weed items I think can be used as a healing items. Let's take a look real quick. 35 hit points to one friend. Okay, so that's just 35. Restores 35 HP, you know, not that great of a healing item, to be honest, but, yeah, there's really, like, one thing I should mention about the white sulfurweed, though, is that if you're a completionist like me and you want to collect all the items in the game, you should at least pick up one before you pick up the red one. Yeah, you should take the red sulfurweed less. I think there's, like, three or four white ones around here. So yeah, you want to pick up all three of the white sulfur weed before you go and, you know, pick the red one up, because once you pick up the red one, the white Fina will say, "We don't need the white ones anymore. Let's go back to the house quickly," and all that. So yeah, probably just shouldn't mention that real quick. Anywho, in the last fight, I cut out. Sue had leveled up her earth magic by one, and now she has a new spell. She has the cure spell. And look at that, she's already got 4 stars because it's a hybrid magic of water and earth magic, but interestingly enough, it's not all the way maxed due to, you know, water being level... Oh, wait, no, it's not level 99, it's level 31. Never mind. But the combined, I think it's like you add both spell levels and then divide by 2 to get how many stars you have. I'm not sure on that. Probably will clarify that, but I know it's like 31 for that. And Snooze is maxed. Yeah, even her strongest healing spells that require a very high level of water magic are maxed. One of her level 3 ones is maxed. So I'm thinking, yeah, it's half of that. So yeah, that's probably why it's only at 4 stars rather than at max. So it'll execute very, very quickly when I use it. And since we're getting a lot of battles here, I might as well show it off in battle since, you know, it's not that major of a thing, but then again, I might as well show the spell effects and all that. You know, why not? Oh, by the way, one thing about digging that also happened in the previous battle is I got it up to like 3 stacks. Thing about status boosting spells like this is you can use them over and over again and they'll stack. So you can get, technically you can get a level 9 buff to defense or something. I don't know exactly what that translates to, but it's that, see the icons down below where Justin is, and one of them is the shield. That'll go up to level 9 before it's maxed, and that means you're going to be able to tank pretty much everything if you get up to level 9 and get it stacked up all the way. But, you can't get away with that. Same generic voice quote from, you know, not using a specific element. You know, for water, you just need a heal, but for like a hybrid with forest, probably not. Anyways, we're now cured of poison, and because this is that one save file that I, that startup save file I made a long time ago, we've all got poison-resistant earrings that you can buy in New Parm. So yeah, that one poison gas that hit pretty much everyone in the party, Justin was not able to, you know, resist it at that time. It's not complete defense against poison, but earrings are better than nothing. And you saw before when I was on the Mirror Road how annoying poison can get. So yeah, you kind of get the idea there. Anyways, back to exploring. If this black screen will go away. There we go. Anyways, yeah, we got, what, 2 white sulfur weeds. And as you might guess, there's a ton of, you know, herbs all around the place. I don't think there's really anything of note as far as, you know, I think everything can get here is, can be store-bought, except for there's, I think, one that's like one of those seed items that you can use to boost your stats. So make sure you pick that thing up whenever you find it. I don't think I found it just yet, but I'm thinking I will sooner or later. Looks like, yep, that's a white one, so I'll take that one too. I gotta find the one with the red flowers. So yeah, you can tell based on the icon as you pick it up here. So, you know, I just want to explore the area fully before you pick up the red one. Anywho, since I'm just kind of wandering around, I might as well change the subject, I suppose. Already announced in Azure Dreams that I'm going to be doing a couple new Let's Plays. First is going to be Brave Fencer Musashi, and I'll be starting that up pretty soon. Second will be Suikoden 1, and then from there we'll go into Suikoden 2. It's kind of relevant to Grandia because the idea behind games like Grandia is I'm going to have a turn-based RPG going at all times on my channel. And if I ever need to stop and grind, well, I have backup Let's Plays, which I can just, you know, pick up and play at any time. Suikoden 3, I'll be doing Suikoden 1 and 2. I don't really need to do much grinding in those games because they're pretty easy to do. But for Suikoden 3, I'll probably be doing some grinding in that Let's Play because of the skill system that they add at that point. But yeah, once we get to Suikoden 3, it'll come after Grandia and take Grandia's place. So, I would like to finish Grandia before I get that far. And I probably gotta go through some monsters to get more items, don't I? So yeah, Suikoden 3 will be that grind-centric turn-based RPG when I get to it. Swinging in 1 and 2 really don't have that problem unless you're going for rare drops, but you know, you don't really need the rare drops in those games, except for maybe some collectible items, but the rare drops are pretty easy to get. The battles go by really quick because they're sprite-based, turn-based battles. And in the Suikoden games, you get six characters at a time in your party, so you can make quick work of most normal monsters. We'll be getting to those when we get there, though. I would like to do more than one update a week. But even so, I try to do about an hour recording session each and every time. Simply just because that works better with my schedule than anything else. But yeah, anyways, I'll try and get more than one episode a week up, even though an hour-long episode does take quite a bit of time to edit and, you know, put together and all that. And geez, with all these fights, it's probably going to take me a good, I don't know, 15 minutes. This episode's probably only going to be like 15 minutes long with all the fights that I'm going to have to cut out from it. So yeah, I'm probably going to be doing like the first episode of Brave Fencer Musashi this week too. And hopefully I'll get both of them up by the weekend. So look forward to my first new Let's Play since the ending of Threads of Fate. And Ambush! And Suikoden 1 might take me a little bit longer to put up because right at the very beginning of the game there's a secret and I plan to do it, and quite literally I have to sit around and grind levels for a while. Even though I just got done saying you probably don't have to do a lot of level grinding in Suikoden 1, or just Suikoden 1 and 2, there's one time at the very beginning of the series where there's a very hidden secret that, you know, will require me to do a bit of level grinding, and I am going to go for it. I do plan to show that one. Anyone who knows that secret probably knows what I'm talking about, but just in case, you know, stay tuned for that. And you know, just look forward to that Let's Play, I suppose. Anyways, in that last fight, Sue learned a new spell because she got to level 3 Earth Magic, so I'll be showing that off pretty soon. Ooh. Hidden herb behind the rock there. And actual weed! put it in your pipe and smoke it, I suppose. I suppose I should get into a fight and show that new spell that Sue got. And I think I've got pretty much everything here already. So, yeah, pretty short episode. We're almost done here. For that, I got a new spell to show off. She hit level 3 Earth Magic, and it was a level 2 spell, kind of like House Slash and Burn Flame. She learned Tremor. Gonna cast it on that Widow there.
Earthquakes are scary!
Ah, sounds like my sister when she was younger. She's like, Earthquakes are scary! Ah. Oh, and I hit circle there. So if you hear a sound effect there, I canceled my auto battle. Might as well set that back up. But anyways, yeah, we gotta see a new spell there. Nothing really much else to show. Oh, by the way, off screen, I also changed my weapons over because, their weapons were getting a bit high. And I'm going to switch over to stuff with a lower skill level. So now, Justin's working on his axes once again. Vina is working on her daggers, and Sue is working on her bows, or throwing skill. I think we've all gained a skill level since then, except for Sue and her bows. But yeah, I'm just gonna work on getting my characters a bit stronger to make up for lack of stats, I suppose. Or, well, we don't really have a lack of stats. We got level 99 water magic. Hold on a sec. I'm going to check my inventory and check a walkthrough I've been using. Like I said before, I've been using the walkthrough by Shotgun Nova, so I'm going to make sure I've got everything. Alright, yes, I do have everything I want. Probably the only items that are worth mentioning are, I would say, get one white sulfur weed if you're trying to collect every item in the game. Three, obviously, might be more interesting. Get the smelling salts, because I don't think you can buy those yet. Maybe you can, I'm not sure. The weeds, I believe, are something you can just, I think the weeds are unique to this area, so you can only get one, I think, in the entire game. Life seed, seed of life, that was the, you know, that's the most important item here, aside from the red sulfur weed, which we need to heal that boy. I found it! This is it! This is red sulfur weed! I thought all of it had withered away by now. Great! Now we can help that child! And, of course, the white sulfur weed is right in the smack dabs in the middle of the mountain here. Anywho, I believe we can jump down using these cliffs. Yep, we can. And we can just follow the spinning magic compass arrow to get back to Fina's house. And probably not going to end out the episode just after that. But yeah, once again, bit of a reminder. About to hit a point of no return. So if you want to go back to New Parham and do your any last minute shopping, I suggest you do that. Be a while before we see a new town. Alright, yeah, it'll be a while before we are able to see a new town after we get through here, because, in case you'd forgotten, the Garlyle forces were... Where is that arrow point? Oh, I should change it. I think the compass actually points to where the sulfur weed is supposed to be. And if you don't change the compass, it won't point you to the exit. So I think it just points to the very center of the map. Anyways, I'll probably repeat myself once I get to the... Get out of here because, you know... People might just be scanning on the YouTube progress bar or whatever. And look for this part where we get back out of the mountain. And look for the green, green grass. But anyways, yep. Just one final reminder, once you give the sulfur weed to that boy, you won't be able to go back to New Parm, and I should probably visit the stashing place now that I think about it, because I got all those herbs and such, and you know, I probably should sell anything that I don't want. I'm probably just going to keep the sulfur weeds, or the white ones, for this whole point of, you know... They're kind of a special item and all that. Even though, you know, they're just basically another type of herb and all that. Yeah. Point of no return coming up soon. Probably the fourth time I've said it by now. I think we're good here. I'm gonna, equip Sue with her rune ring now that we're out of poison enemy territory, and I don't think I'll need the earrings anymore. Since it's the law of RPGs, is the story doesn't proceed until you make it proceed, let's have a meal before we go off into the unknown and, you know, the Garlyle forces get in our way, like I said. Kind of a hint there, and we'll be seeing, find out very soon. Oh, same spicy food combination, or conversation, combination. What? Getting my words mixed up there. Not even thinking about what I'm saying here, but yeah. Let's go give that herb to that little boy, because you know, that's a good thing. You know, helping out. You know, whatever he is. We did see that he had a horn and a tail and all that, so he is not human, but he's mostly human, so yeah, I don't know what's going on with that, but, you know, we'll probably find out more about him later. Gone back inside, and we automatically get this cutscene. Well, the fever is down. That's a relief for now, anyway. I'm glad. Phew, I wondered what would happen. That's a relief for me, too. And... I don't know if you noticed that there, but Sue's already asleep over in the corner there. Kind of a bit of foreshadowing to something later, but I should at least point it out now. Anyway, still, I'd like to know what kind of creature this is. It's got a tail and everything. Consider where he collapsed. Maybe he's from the Misty Forest. In that case, Maybe he's got something to do with Angelo. What do you think? I'll bet that's it. Maybe that's why he's got a tail and those horns. I don't know if he's really jumping to conclusion or if he's connecting the dots here. Remember the Icarians that Liette keeps telling us about and the myths and legends that we've heard about in the very beginning of the game? The Icarians are winged people, so they also have things that normal humans do not have, that, you know, animal parts and all that. So maybe he's making the connection here that this little boy might be connected to them. And he's actually got extra long ears if you're looking at his sprite in the bed there. Anyways, hey, Fina, what if this kid really is an Icarian? Shh! Don't talk so loud, Justin. You'll wake him up. Sorry, Fina. I guess I got a little worked up. really now, Justin. I got no idea whether he has anything to do with Angelo. Got a lot to ask when he wakes up. Since he's injured, I think it's only right we should take him back to his home. I agree. I hope we find more about him when he comes to and talks. You'd better get to sleep, Justin. I'll watch over him tonight. Fina, you should sleep soon, too. I mean, you've had quite a big day, after all. Theoretically, we have only been awake for about 5 minutes since we took the road back from New Parm, but story-wise, we came here straight from the Dom Ruins and went to Herb Mountain, so it's been a long day. And I think the day started at Wrangle Mountains, of all places, because that was the last time we had an actual camp scene. Anyways, yeah, I know. Well, good night, Justin. Okay, I don't think I've ever heard the full loop of that flute song, but I don't know if you could hear it in the background. I'll probably turn it up for you to hear. But there's a flute playing in the background, and you can see Fina's also, she just kind of passed out there on the floor, or I don't know if she's leaning on the bed, but she was looking after him, and now the boy's gone. What's that? What's that strange music? Hey, Justin, wake up! Fina, I must have dozed off. Huh? Anyways, it's kind of a sweet little song that he's playing out there. Obviously, that kid is the one playing the flute. Anyway, oh no! Fina, Justin, the kid is gone! Huh? Oh, I wonder where he went. That wound hasn't healed yet. I hear a flute. Where's the sound coming from? It's coming from outside. Let's go see, Justin. Alright, so perhaps we'll learn a little bit about this boy. Anyways, we've already passed the point of no return because we entered Fina's house. There'll be an event here coming up real soon with that boy. And we will no longer be able to visit New Parm after this. So yeah, if you're following along, last chance you get to go to New Parm was right before we entered Fina's house. Anyways, there he is! He's standing there on the rock there, and he's playing his flute. Now, interesting thing about this character, you see he's kind of got a bit of a unique character design, and he's going to be playing an important part in the story for the next several segments of the game. He might actually be even more important from a game developer standpoint because, got a unique portrait and all that. Looks like he's talking in Hylian and all that. I don't know if you've ever played the Zelda games, but, or at least the earlier Zelda games. But that text reminds me of some of the tablets you look on in Legend of Zelda Link to the Past. You need to get that one book to translate them. That's just what it reminds me of. But anyways, he's got his big smile on his face, the little boy, and, you know, he's got horns and a tail and all that. Hey, what's your name? I'm Sue. You know, I don't think it's human, is it? It's got such a strange voice. But it seems to be saying something. Maybe it's just speaking a different language. Another language? You mean there are other languages besides ours? Hey, little guy, what's your name? Where are you from? But yeah, I'll be getting into this guy a little bit later, why I think he's more important from a game development standpoint. But it's a little too early to be talking about that. But eventually I'll get to that point of that I'm trying to make. Anyways, we're not getting anywhere. I don't think I can understand it. Huh? What's going on? He suddenly reached for that nut. What will you do with it? Maybe it's a thank you gift. I think he wants you to eat it. I've never seen one like that before. I don't know. Hey, Justin, try a bite. Hmm? Uh-oh. Tanks! Tank, tank, tank. The Garlisle forces are here in these. Yeah. What bad luck to run into these three again. And I'm probably referring to them as the three young women. Because the official song that plays for these girls on the soundtrack is called The Three Young Women. So collectively, Dena, Mio, and Saki will be called The Three Young Women when I'm referring to all three of them at once. Anyways, I finally found you, you little beast. Trying to give us a hard time. La 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 la. Who are you? Take a look, good look, and see. You'll see, we're soldiers in the Garlisle forces. Now hand over that humanoid. Humanoid? Then you mean this thing's really human? See, didn't I meet you and the little girl at the Salt Ruins? What an odd place to meet again. You guys don't have a choice here. Now hand over the humanoid or accept the consequences. Boy, you sure are bossy. Why are you so interested in a little humanoid like this? We rescued this kid. Why should we hand him over without even knowing why? Yeah, that's right. Don't be so tyrannical. What? I've had enough of this idle chatter. I don't even know what tyrannical means. These humanoids are classified as top secret under the Garlisle Forces plan. Hand him over or we'll kill you all. Top secret. Garlisle Forces plan. Hey, Saki, you bland about top secret matter. Try thinking before you talk. Well, I had no choice. Either way, we had to take these guys back to base. Yeah, now that they know too much, of course we have to. Enough of this nonsense. Think we're just going to give up quietly? Anon, you three have no right to disobey us. You want hard labor and starvation? Alright, soldiers, take them to our frontline base. Oh, boy. And there we go, Garlisle boy base. I wasn't kidding when I was saying that we were going to pass the point of no return. And, well, now we've passed that point. Long after that point. Anyways, cutting. And we are now prisoners of war. Even though there's no war going on, but still. Should at least mention that, you know, we're probably not gonna in a good situation, are we? They got a lot of heavy grade equipment here, and we're not ones to really get our heads shot off because of all this. For now, see what we got here. They're gonna take that little boy away, and the rest of us are going down to the basement, obviously to some sort of cell block. And first order of business should be to really find a save point, because, well, I want to explore this place in full next episode. But, you know, we've got a few things to do before we get there. Brett, let's get out of here! Oh-ho, prepare to die, because you won't get out alive again. Get out again alive. Anyways, isn't this lovely? Now we can have a real execution. What would be the best method? Well, let's go, Nana and Mio. Why are the two of you here when you were taking that little boy off? I don't know, continuity errors. Anyways, listen, be relentless, put your hearts into it, be on the lookout. And they left one guard to guard two little children like us. Anyways, not too smart considering we gave you guys a slip last time at the Salt Ruins. So yeah, they remembered us from then. The reason they found us is that, if you forget, they used their search dogs when we found, in that scene where we found the little boy for the first time in the outskirts of the Dom Ruins. And that's eventually how they found us. Probably took them a night to do so, and then, you know, led them straight to us, I suppose. Anyways, they're gone. What do we do now, Justin? Can't use our weapons either. Anyways, I have to escape from here somehow. And let's rattle our cage. Can we cold cock them? Yes, we can, because there's a pipe here. Grab a pipe. What's this? Hefty pipe acquired. Ooh, it's got a nice good swing to it. And apparently, even though we've got a pipe with us, they forgot to confiscate all our equipment. At least I think they did. I think we still have all our items and stuff on us. It's just, you know, for story purposes, maybe they didn't actually. I don't know. I don't know where I'm going with it. Great, got a hold of a weapon. Now, how do we escape from here? Obviously, we're going to beat the crap out of the guard there. I know. Let's do it that way, Sue. Of course, standard escape plan 101. Yes, I understand, Justin. Oh! Tummy hurts! Yow! My stomach, ow! Ouch! My tummy hurts! Oh, hey, listen up. Sue's in bad shape. What are you gonna do? Shut up! What is it? Sue's in bad shape! Yow! My stomach hurts! Hey, hurry, take her to the doctor's. Oh, you little brat. Wait a second, I'm opening it now. Of course, doesn't this, like, work all the time, pretty much? Of course, take that pipe and beat the guard over his head. Hey, it worked, Justin! Aha, my strategy never fails! Come, now we must rescue Vina and the boy and escape from here! Of course. So, we got him. Did I overdo it? Sorry about that, guy. Got a very hefty-looking door there. More futuristic than that little shoddy cell there, but... Fina's in the cell next door. Justin, you came for me. Fina, wait. I'm opening it right now. Rattle. Good. No good. It won't open. Stop that, Justin. You can't bust it open. You have to use the key. That's right, Justin. There's a room in back. There might be a key there. You're right. All right, let's go take a look. And now we are Solid Snake. No good. Looks like one only wears a key. How about you? I see humanoids in another room. You must be looking right now, right? Snake. Solid Snake this way. There are only two children. Look out, we'll be just fine. Don't worry. Doesn't realize that they're talking on an intercom. Yeah! Okay, so we pretty much just gave ourselves away because he was talking to someone. Probably doesn't understand this high-tech stuff, but anyways, see, Justin, that human mind must be that boy. Alright, I'll rescue him! Key! And potion. What do we got? The resurrection potion, a good thing to have, especially since, you know, we're Got no stores in sight. Probably no healing. We still don't have a save point in sight. And of course, we just set off the alarm by, you know, beating the crap out of that guy and making him scream like a little girl. And, you know, they kind of figured out that he'd been beaten over the head. So they all came all at once. So, you know what? You twit! Pow, 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 pow. That was so violent that they had to fade to black and use a cartoon sequence instead. Drat, only one more step away. Rats, let me out of here. What are you going to do with that? Say something. Shut up. Quiet in there. Look here. We're going to escape. Remember that. Oh. It's that one girl before. The one officer that wasn't a total bitch. How is the middle prisoner? They've kept on shouting ever since. They won't quiet down at all. Is that so? I'll talk with the prisoners. Let me pass. You said your name was Justin. You really made a fool of us. What are you saying? Look at how bad you treated us at SALT. Now untie this rope right away. Let me see Fina. Shut up. I will not allow you to mouth off like that. You know too much about military secrets, about ancient culture and humanoids. Punish you three will be decided within a week. It should be the death sentence. You think we'll go quietly to a death sentence? I'll break out. I'll show you. I said, don't mouth off! You spin me right round, baby, right round. Ah, crud, I dare you to do it! I'll remember this! Do you seriously think you can escape from here? Perhaps you're here alone, but you can't all escape. Unless you stall a military train. Ooh. Huh? A military train? All you can do right now is wait until we carry out your sentence. Be quiet until then. Don't know why she's mentioning that military train, but she apparently might be on our side? I don't know, maybe she's just trying to play dumb. But anyways, we will soon get our next orders from Colonel Mullen. You men stand by in the other room. But, Lieutenant Lane, don't we have to watch this punk? Leave him alone. If he makes any more ruckus, I don't mind if you kill him. Yes, ma'am. Excuse us. And now she's getting rid of the guards for us. I've been thinking this over, and there's still plenty of time until they carry out your sentence. Ooh. Freaky. Ha 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 ha! I remember that one giving me a slap like that. Well, what do I do now? First, I have to do something with this rope. Hey, I think I can wriggle out. Somehow. And apparently, that slap that she gave us also loosened the rope for Justin to get out of here. A little more. I did it! Great! This time I'll get away! Probably be a bit more subtle about that because you are no solid snake, Justin. What? Could this be? Great! It's a jail key! That woman called Lean dropped it. She really is a dunce. No, Justin. You missed all the signs. She wants us to escape. Oh, anyways. Well, enough about a key there. So they put Sue in with Fina. Justin, you're alright! She's so happy! Wait, Fina, open it for you now. You'd probably get a lecture on how he should be a bit more subtle because he just stirred the whole hornet's nest last time. Anyways, thank you, Justin. That was an easy one. I'm amazed you got out of your cell. What kind of magic did he use? Fire, that's it. Fire, fire, fire. The truth is, a soldier came around a little while ago and I heard a few things. Then she dropped the jail key. She was so stupid, that's how I escaped. Wow, that's a little hard to believe. So you were saved thanks to her. Hey, Justin, before we escape, let's go rescue the humanoid boy. Of course we will. Well then, hurry, let's go look for that child before they come after us. Alright, and hopefully we'll get a save point pretty soon. I think we'll get one just outside the jail here, and I don't know. Is there an item in there? Could swear there was an item in one of those lockers, but maybe that's later in this place. I don't remember, but I'm pretty sure you get something out of a locker sooner or later. For now, though, I think we go just outside, and it's a little bit nighttime here. Yeah, it's a... No, you know, we're still inside. Anywho, we got an item here. Let's pick it up. Ultra drink, I believe? I think that looks like something we should check out here. Ultra drink restores 20 SP to the entire party. Not quite a gold potion, but... Or... Was it a gold elixir or something? But, you know... I think we're just about done here. I got a save point. Obviously should have a hint for the day. What skill levels? Using in weapons and skills, when their skill levels are low, gives additional experience points. This way you can easily increase lagging skills. I've kind of gone over that before. On the flip side, if you use weapon or magic skills too much of the same family, they'll go up much slower because it's based on the enemy you're hitting with that skill. Anyways, last minute tip for the day. I suppose I should just save here and call it a day. So I should say thanks for watching.